Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic that is nitrogen cycle. So let's continue our session. The steps involved in the nitrogen cycle are basically nitrogen fixation, nitrogen assimilation, ammonification, nitrification, and denitrification. So let's see the first step, that is nitrogen fixation. Basically, in nitrogen fixation, the nitrogen gas is converted into the inorganic nitrogen gas compound, and it is mostly 90%. That means 90% nitrogen gas is accomplished by free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. So these nitrogen fixing bacteria are mostly present in the soil, and these bacteria, free living nitrogen fixing bacteria, for example Azotobacter and Rhizobium, they fixes, or you can say they convert the nitrogen gas present in the air into the inorganic nitrogenous compounds in the soil. And these nitrogen fixing bacteria are mostly present in the legumes of the plants, in the leguminous plants. These nitrogen fixing bacteria are basically called as the symbiotic bacteria living in the roots of the plants, and these plants mostly have legumes and alders. Cyanobacteria, formerly known as the blue-green algae, an example of nitrogen fixing bacteria. Another archaebacteria, which is also known as archae, in the deep sea hydrothermal vents it is found. So this is an example of nitrogen fixing bacteria. It has symbiotic function with the plant. That means the plant provides, you can say, a shelter, or in response to this, that these bacteria are fixing atmospheric nitrogen and giving it to the plants as a nutrient source. In return, this plant again gives some nutrients to the bacteria for their survival. So this is a symbiotic relationship, or you can say symbiotic association, between nitrogen fixing bacteria and the plants. Next comes the nitrogen assimilation. This contains assimilation of nitrates and ammonia resulting from the nitrogen fixation into the specific compounds of algae and higher plants, and animals then ingest these algae and plants, converting them into their own body compounds. That means after that, what happens after the after formation of this inorganic nitrogenous compounds, they are converted into nitrates and ammonia, and they are fixed, or you can say they are in the tissues of the compounds of the, you can say, these plants. And these plants, when eaten up by the humans, or you can say by the animals, what happens, their body converted them into their own body compounds. Okay, next comes the ammonification. Now the remains of all the living things and their waste products are decomposed by the microorganism, which yields ammonia. After that, what happens when these animals, or you can say human beings, not the human beings, but whenever these animals die, what happens? The dead decomposed, or even plants also, the remains of plants also, when the waste is decomposed by the microorganisms, they yield ammonia. Okay, so this ammonia is again, can say, released in the atmosphere. Next comes the nitrification. It is a process in which is carried out by nitrifying bacteria, which transforms the soil ammonia into nitrates, and nitrates which plant can incorporate into their tissues. Next comes the denitrification process, in which the process where nitrates are metabolized by denitrifying bacteria to free nitrogen and return it to the atmosphere. So this is basically the last step, which is in the conversion of nitrates of nitrogen by the denitrifying bacteria. So students, in this session we have seen about the nitrogen cycle.